The next part of our meeting is then to talk about, give you some input. And last week we spoke about the food chain, and tonight we're going to focus on the importance of protein. Now, last week we said you are the result of what you eat, and your body then breaks down whatever you eat in the form of food components that we can classify as carbohydrates, lipids and sterols, protein, minerals, vitamins, and enzymes. And a few weeks ago, we explained to you how absolutely important it is in whatever you do, and make it sure at least you'd start with 3NN, because at cellular level, that is what's feeding the cells on a daily basis, so that food and vitamins and minerals can come in and do the work in the body, excrete waste products, and you have a high energy individual. If you don't have it, you become this person, food can't come in, the cell becomes like plastic, and waste can't get out, and you've got a sick, sluggish individual. And 3NN builds cell membrane. It's a starting point of manufacturing prostaglandin, which is the basic building block to all the hormones, and also balance water levels. So if you know of any, and also ladies through their menopause, and who struggle with all the hot flushes, get them onto at least three NNs a day, just to break that bad cycle of menopause. Then we just looked at, and that's a typical look of the 3NN, then we looked at the rest of the products, and we say, for your minerals, vitamins, and enzymes, we have a product called Formula 4 Plus. And Formula 4 Plus also has the lipids and sterols in it, or you can get that extra. So go back to last week's training on that. So tonight I want to focus on protein. Now, protein is one of the most misunderstood words when it comes to nutrition. Next to water and oxygen, the third most important thing that your body needs on a daily basis are proteins. But protein, the name protein is like a collective name for what we call amino acids. And amino acids is also not just one thing. You have essential amino acids, there are 9 of them, and non-essential amino acids, and 14 of them. And essential, the word essential says your body cannot synthesize it. You need to obtain it from the food source, and it can be plant or animal or a combination. Whereas non-essential doesn't mean your body don't need it. It just said that if you are deficient in any one of them, provided that you have all 9 amino acids, then the body will manufacture and synthesize what it needs on this size. So you can take it from your food source, or the body can synthesize it. And the previous slide was just a typical immunoglobulin, which then is part of the antibody system. And the blue is then just a illustration of, it's a very complex molecule chain, which floats then around your body. And when it sees foreign matter, it binds with them before they can do damage to your cell. But we're going to talk more about that. So what are food sources of protein? Well, the obvious one that we think of normally is meat. But did you know that meat only have about 12 amino acids? So if you want to get all your 22 plus amino acids from meat, you have to eat the whole cow, the hoof, the udder, the skin, and so forth. So any one of you out there ready to do that? If not, you need to really know how to combine your food sources so that you can get the correct balance of 22 amino acids out of that. And one source are eggs, another source are dairy products, another source are seeds and nuts, another source are beans and legumes, and the final one is then soy products. But, you know, we eat these things, but we don't eat it on a daily basis. So it's only if you're a food scientist that you know exactly whether you are balancing your diet correctly. So why do you need all these amino acids in the body, the essentials and non-essentials? Well, all your antibodies are made up of protein, or combinations of amino acids. And did you know that your body has the intelligence that even if it's the most foreign new bacteria floating around in the air, within half an hour of that bacteria entering your body, your body's mechanisms can identify that foreign intruder and then design an antibody customized just for that intruder and then stop it in its tracks. And this process happens hundreds and thousands of times every day in our body. The problem is if at that point in time where it can identify the intruder and now send the signal to go and make an antibody and you don't have the correct amino acids or you are deficient in some of the essential amino acids, then although the body knows how to fight this intruder, it can't make the antidote. And you can then start becoming ill from that sickness. Enzymes. Enzymes are the food processes happening to break down big food and also carry out all the chemical reactions that take place in the cell. Secondly, all your hormones are dependent on the quality of amino acids in your body. And like messenger proteins, you need those microscopic amounts of hormones. But what is the one that make you take flight or if you just escape my mind now. But whether it's estrogen or testosterone or adrenaline is the one, you need the amino acids to help you to be effective there. Then everything you see in the mirror, hair, nails, skin, so that recovery process, if you cut yourself, the recovery process of bones breaking or organs, it's all dependent on the quality of protein. And then it also transport like oxygen to the cells. And so they bind and carry atoms and small molecules within the cells and throughout the body, even right to the brain. So as you can see, a good balance of protein is very important. Now, here's a problem. Many of the so-called supplements out there are low in what we call protein efficiency ratio. And a protein efficiency ratio is another way of saying how much of what you are consuming is actually converted by the body for all the bodily processes. So check for a good PER ratio. And our one that we recommend to you from New Life is one of the highest on the market and has a ratio of 2.4. So for every gram of protein intake, 2.4, the effect of it, it then benefits the body 2.4 times. Then also just another thing you need to know, how much do you need? It depends on your body weight, but for every kilogram of body, 0.8 gram of protein, so 80 kilogram person would need 64 grams of protein on a daily basis. And again, when we say protein, it's not just meat. It's the full combination of all the essential and non-essential amino acids. So if you want to make sure, and you're not a food scientist, one of my secret recipes for the last 38 years, whenever I travel into Africa, I had a regime. The first thing I packed is my LDC for washing and bathing. And then I would pack my vitality pack, which is that combination of the 3NN and the vitamins and minerals. And I would pack a NutriShake or a New Life shake, and it comes in different flavors with a protein ratio, efficiency ratio of 2.4. But then I can carry on and I have meetings and my energy outlasts the people that I'm working with. And all of this, complete balanced protein meal for less than 35 rand a meal. So it's 20 servings per container. And that's it. If you need to know more about it, speak to your legacy coach. Tell you more about where you can get it.